Good morning, students. I, Vijaya, your teacher of English, welcome you all to Rishikul Online School. Today, I am going to discuss with you all Chapter 9 from the book Footprints Without Feet. Name of the chapter is Bholi, written by K.A. Abbas. This is Module 2. In our previous module, we read that Bholi's father, Ramlal, was very much worried about Bholi because Bholi was not like other children. She fell off a cot as a child, due to which her brain was slightly damaged. She learned to speak very late and used to stammer. Her face and whole body was covered with the marks of smallpox. Thus, her father was worried about her marriage prospects. Now, what happens next in the story? Come on, let's read and know. That night, when Ramlal consulted his wife, she cried, "Are you crazy? If girls go to school, who will marry them?" But Ramlal had not the courage to disobey the tehsildar. At last his wife said, "I'll tell you what to do. Send Bholi to school. As it is, there is a little chance of her getting married with her ugly face and lack of sense. Let the teachers at school worry about her." So this paragraph tells that his parents, his mother and father, both were not concerned about her. They assumed their daughter as very ugly and she lacked sense. So, as Ramlal was a government official and Tehsildar had asked Ramlal to send his daughters to new school in the village. So the mother said, and she suggested her husband that you must send Bholi to the school, just to justify the Tehsildar. And he got agreed. The next day, Ramlal caught Bholi by hand and said, "Come with me, I'll take you to school." Bholi was frightened. She did not know what a school was like. She remembered how a few days ago their old cow Lakshmi had been turned out of the house and sold. "No, no, 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 no." She shouted in terror and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. Sulekha or Bholi, she was not healthy and strong. She was frightened at first when her father wanted to take her to school, but when she was given good dresses to wear, she thought, "Really, I'm going to a nice place, a place that is much better to my home." "What's the matter with you, you fool?" shouted Ramla. "I'm only taking you to school." Then he told his wife, "Let her wear some decent clothes today. As else, what will the teachers and other schoolgirls think of us when they see her?" New clothes had never been made for Bholi. The old dresses of her sister were passed on to her. No one cared to mend or wash her clothes. But today she was lucky to receive a clean dress which had shrunk after many washing and no longer fitted champa. She was even bathed, and oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. Only then did she begin to believe that she was being taken to a place better than her home. So here she got realized that exactly she was going to a better place where she is given good dresses to wear. She is given good look. She was glad. She hoped that everything would be fine now. When they reached school, the children were already in the classroom. Ram Lal handed over the daughter to the headmistress. Left alone, the poor girl looked about her with fear-laden eyes. There was several room, and in each room, girls like her squatted on mats, reading from books or writing on slates. The headmistress asked Bholi to sit down in a corner in one of the classrooms, and she followed the same, but she was full of fear. She wanted to know what is happening here. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls, but Bholi could understand nothing. She looked at the pictures on the wall. The colors fascinated her. The horse was brown, just like the horse on which the tahsildar had come to visit their village. The goat was black, like the goat of their neighbor. The parrot was green, like the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard. And the cow was just like their Lakshmi. And suddenly, Bholi noticed that the teacher was standing by her side, smiling at her. "What's your name, little bird?" the teacher asked. At first, Bholi was afraid at school. She even wept when the teacher asked her name. She just sat in a corner. But the beautiful picture on the classroom wall attracted her. The gentle, kind, and loving manner of the teacher made her comfortable. And now, what happened next in the story, we will read in our next module. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you.